Hello students, in our previous lecture, we have started with our exercise 13.2. We have discussed first 6 questions of exercise 13.2. Now in this, we will discuss the remaining questions. So let's start with question number 7. Question number 7 says that inner diameter of a circular bowl, circular well is 3.5 meter. So diameter is given as 3.5 meter, right? Now, and it is 10 meter deep. Height is given as 10 meter, right? Now it says that find its inner curved surface area first part, and let's first find out the first. It is asking us to find curved surface area. What is the formula for the curved surface area of a cylinder? It is we have to find the curved surface area. It is 2πRh. The curved surface area is 2πRh. And if we have to find the total surface area, what is the total surface area? It is 2πRh+R, right? So, 2πRh is the curved surface area. Now we have to find, just put the values. So what will be the radius? Diameter is given, so radius will be 3.5 upon 2. So 2 into 22 by 7 into 3.5 upon 2 into 10. This decimal we take it down. So 5, it gets cancelled out. So we get 110 meter square. That is the curved surface area of the well. Now the second part says that cost of plastering this curved surface, at the rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So cost of plastering will be, cost of plastering 1 meter square is rupees 40. So cost of plastering 110 meter square will be 110 into 40. It comes out to be rupees 4400 rupees is the cost of plastering the entire well, inner surface area of the well. So this was question number 7. I hope the question is clear. It was very easy. Let's move on to question number 8 now. Let me just drop this quickly. Question number 8 of exercise 13.2. Question number 8 says that in a hot water heating system, there is a cylindrical pipe of length 28 meter and diameter 5 centimeter. Find the total radiating surface in the system. So it says that the length of the pipe is given. Length of pipe is 28 meter, right? And diameter is given as 5 centimeter. We have to find the total radiating surface in the system. That means we have to find the curved surface area. So diameter is given as 5 centimeter, right? What will be the radius? Radius will be 2.5 centimeter. Now the length is given in meter, so let's change this is also in meter. So it comes out to be 0.025 meter, right? Now what will be the curved surface area? Curved surface area is 2πRh. So 2 into 22 by 7 into R is 25 upon 1000 into 28. So this get cancelled out, we get 4 this gets cancelled out, we get 40, 10, and we get 4.4 meter square. 4.4 meter square, that is the total radiating surface in the system, right? So very easy question, you just have to, the important thing in these questions is you have to see what the question is asking, whether it is asking you a curved surface area or the volume or the total surface area, right? So that is the most important part. So this was question number 8. Let's move on to question number 9 now. Let me just rub this quickly. Question number 9. Question number 9 says that find the lateral curved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage tank that is 4.2 meter in diameter and 4.5 meter high. Right? So, we have to find the curved surface area first. So, the height of tank is 4.5 meter and diameter of tank is 4.2 meter. First of all, we will find the radius. Radius of tank will be 4.2 upon 2 equal to 2.1 meter. Now the first part is asking us find the lateral surface area. So curved surface area will be 2 pi rh. So we just put the values 2 by 22 by 7 into 2.1 into 4.5. This get cancelled out, 0.3, right? And on solving this we get 59.4 meter square. That is the curved surface area of the closed cylindrical petrol tank, right? This was the first part. Now, second part is saying how much steel was used if 1 by 12th of the steel actually used was wasted in making the tank. Now, the question is saying that it is a closed tank. They are asking us how much steel was actually used, right? So, this was the curved surface area, but for making the entire tank, we need the total surface area. So, total surface area will be 2 pi r h plus r, right? So, 2 into 22 by 7 into 2.1 into 4.5 plus 2.1. So, we get 22 into 0.6 into 6.6. When we solve this, we get 87.12 meter square. That is the steel used in making that tank. But the question is saying that 1 by 12th of the total steel which was used was wasted, and after that this was used to make the tank. So what was the actual steel required before wasting, right? So I am rubbing this part. Let total steel required is equal to x meter square. We take it as x meter square. Right? Now, steel wasted will be, it is 1 by 12th of total, so it will be x by 12 meter square, right? Now, we can say that x minus x by 12, total steel minus steel wasted must be equal to total surface area of that total steel required in making in making that tank, which is equal to 87.12 meter square, right? When we cancel it out, we get 11 by 12 x is equal to 87.12, and when we solve this, we get 87.12 upon 11 into 12. On solving this, we get 95.04 meter square. The calculations are a bit messy, so but you can easily solve this, right? I have solved the numericals in advance so that it won't take much time. So the total steel which was required before wasting, initially we started with 95.04 meter square steel which was required to make that after wasting also, right? So this was question number 9, a very easy question again. I hope the questions are clear. Now we move on to question number 10th. Let me just drop this quickly. Question number 10th. In figure 13.12, first of all, let's draw the figure. The figure is somewhat like this. This is the figure given to us. Now the question says, in figure 13.12, you see the frame of the lampshade. It is covered with a decorative cloth. The frame has a base diameter of 20 centimeter. This is 20 centimeter. This is 20 centimeter given to us. Right? And height of 30 centimeter. Right? Height is given as 30 centimeter. A margin of 2.5 centimeter is to be given for folding it over the top and bottom of the frame. The question is that height is 30 centimeter, but a margin of 2.5 centimeter at the top, this margin and this margin, this is 2.5 centimeter each, which is given for folding the decorative cloth. So total height comes out to be 35 centimeter, right? Now the question is saying, find how much cloth is required for covering the lampshade. Very easy question. This is a decorative cloth which is only on the sides of the lamp. There is no upside and there is no downside. So we just have to find the curved surface area, right? Only the important part is in this question is that the height which is given as 30 centimeter, we have to add 2.5 centimeter at the bottom and 2.5 centimeter at the top also, which the cloth which is required for covering it, right? So height of 35 centimeter cloth, it will be 35 centimeter. I have told you why 35, right? Diameter is 20 centimeter. So what will be radius? It will be 10 centimeter, 20 by 2. 10 centimeter, right? Now curved surface area is 2 pi r h. Just simply put the values 2 into 22 by 7 into 10 into 35. This gets cancelled out. It comes out to be 5. And on solving this, we get 2200 centimeter square. A very easy question. What was the main part which we have to understand in this question was this margins of 2.5 centimeter above and 2.5 centimeter below. This was the main part in which we have to understand, right? Again, a very easy question. This was question number 10th. Now we move on to the last question of this exercise, which is question number 11th. Let me just rub this. Question number 11 says that a student of a vidyalaya, the students of a vidyalaya were asked to participate in a competition for making and decorating pen holders in the shape of a cylinder with a base using cardboard. Each pen holder was to be of radius 3 cm and height 10.5 cm. The Vidyalaya was to supply the competitors with cardboard. If there were 35 competitors, how much cardboard was required to be bought for the competition? Very easy question again. What was the question? The radius of the pen holder was given. Radius of pen holder is 3 cm. Right? And height of pen holder was 10.5 cm. Right? Now, for making the pen holder, it is said that the sides and the base is included. So what will be the surface area? Surface area will be 2 pi r h plus area of base, which is pi r square. So it comes out to be pi r into 2 h plus r. So when we put the values, we get 22 by 7 into r is 3. 2 h is 2 into 10.5 plus r. So we get 22 by 7. This we get 66 by 7 into 21 plus r is 3 plus 3. We get 66 by 7 into 24 centimeter square. Now this is surface area of one pen holder. Surface area of one pen holder is 66 by 7 into 24. Now surface area of 35 pen holders, it will be 66 by 7 into 24 into 35. It gets cancelled out, we get 5. And on solving this, we get 66, 24 into 5 is 120, 6, 12, 7. We get 7920 centimeter square. This is the total cardboard required for the competition. So what was the question? A very easy question. It was given that in a vidyalaya there is a competition going on in which each competitor has to make a pen holder which has a side and a base, and the dimensions of the pen holder were given to us, right? So we first of all what we did, and it was asked that there are total 35 competitors in the competition, then what is the total area of cardboard required? So what we did, first of all we found the surface area of the one pen holder, and we didn't solve the entire equation here only, we kept it like this. You can solve it also if you want. Then what is the surface area of 35 pen holders? We simply multiply it by 35, and on solving this we get 7920 centimeters square. So this is the total amount of cardboard required for the competition. So this was question number 11 of exercise 13.2. With this we have completed our exercise 13.2. In the next lecture we will start with our exercise 13.3. So thank you very much.